We are live. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Claudia Marcu. I am a former correspondent of the public radio in Romania. And in the present time, I'm freelancing for the cultural channel of Radio Romania. This session is organized by RomPro Foundation, and the aim is very simple, to familiarize the Romanian community with the Dutch political landscape and of course the electoral process. We have less than 2 weeks, I think maybe 1.5 weeks to the elections. This evening is very short, but as the Dutch say, is kort en krachtig. We have two guests, a journalist and a writer with some Romanian roots, background, Stefan Popa or Stefan Popa. He will be with us in the first half an hour, and in the second half, we will be joined by the mayor of Diemen, Mr. Eric Boog. I think he's already online, and I have to say we are very grateful that he could be with us longer than expected. But let's start. We have first about 20 minutes with Stefan, and we reserved the last 10 minutes from each half an hour for your questions. So, Stefan, can you hear us?
Yes.
Good evening. Welcome. Good evening, Stefan. I will stick with Stefan or Christian. He told me today that his name is also Christian. It sounds very Romanian. We met in 2014. It's a very long time ago. You grew very much as a writer since then. And I'm very happy to welcome you this evening as an independent journalist.
Yes, yes, thank you. And I'm happy to see you also. It's a long time, but it was a nice conversation back then, and I hope it will be nice again.
I hope so. Well, Stefan, it seems that we have a very different political landscape with a lot of parties, small and big, traditional and less traditional. Can you make an image? Can you draw it for us a little bit in a few words?
It's almost impossible right now. The last elections we had, I think 27 parties to choose between, and now we have 37, so 10 more parties, and we have got, what you said, a lot of small parties. But the big parties are still the favorite, D66, CDA, so the Liberals, the Socialist Party, the Labour Party, the Christian parties, of course. So there's a lot
more or less traditional ones.
Yes, yes, yes. True.
Okay. And how can we explain this phenomenon of the little parties, the fragmentation of the political landscape?
Oh, that's a good question. You know, I think it's the Dutch, many Dutch voters are saying each time again, it doesn't matter on which party you vote, because after the elections, they are going to sit together at the table and then they are going to negotiate some things. And at the end of the day, you don't get what you vote on. So people are angry, and that's why we got a lot of new parties coming up, left and right. So that's one reason, but it's a very big question to answer right now.
It's difficult, yeah, indeed.
Yeah, it's difficult, but yeah, you at the end of the day, you have always have to negotiate in Dutch politics, and polderen, as we call it in Dutch, and at the end of the day we have to put some water with the wine, as we say in the Netherlands, and that's not a bad thing, I think. So very
it's,
you know how it works, and I think it works great in this way. And my father is from Transylvania, so he likes to put some water into white wine, a good spritz in the summer. So
it's good to mention maybe that in this country you will never have a party with a majority. It will always be a coalition,
Yeah.
This is the, let's say, the what you mentioned, the polling.
Yeah.
So when we look
right
at
now, from four parties, one big party, the VVD, and the CDA and D66, so the Christian Party and the Democratic Party, of the mayor also, and the Christian Union, and they are forming the government right now, and we'll see what will be the next government.
When we look at the new landscape with the new parties, which are, let's say, which of these parties have some chances to enter the parliament?
I looked at the polls today. So we've got relative new Forum of Democracy. They are already in parliament, but they will be back. Part of Forum, ex-Forum politicians are going to be in parliament as well, probably with one seat. And Volt, a pro-European party.
This is really a new kid on the block.
Yeah. So we don't know for sure because the polls are very different. We got four major polls in the Netherlands, and we don't know what will be the outcome, of course, but there will be some new kids in the block.
Well, let's talk a little bit about the themes in the debate. What are the important themes for the society? Or I have to say, how are the parties choosing these themes for their programs?
Well, they're looking at what do we want? What do the voters want? So a big thing, of course, is climate change is one big aspect of life right now, and migration, COVID, of course. Almost forgot COVID, but COVID is pretty important.
It's fashionable now, yes.
Yeah. Yeah, we are done with COVID, but COVID is not done with us, so we have to talk about COVID a lot. Healthcare, and so what can we do to prevent a crisis in the future? How are we going to pay our people in healthcare? Safety, discrimination, equality. So there are a lot of topics. The economy, of course. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It is very difficult to have a campaign in this period talking about COVID. It's very difficult for the parties to meet with the voters. It is also very difficult for voters to get the information in a good way, in the way they were maybe used to.
Yeah.
They have to adapt. When we look at this aspect of the voter, so let's say from the voter point of view, how can I, as a foreigner in this country, adopted citizen, can get the right information to vote, if I am allowed to vote, if I have the right to vote, to get the right information to make the right decision for myself?
Yeah, that's a very good question. I think if you don't speak Dutch, you can manage quite easily in the Netherlands, but in the voting process it's a little bit more difficult. What I like to do, and that's a test, you can make a test online, the kieswijzer or stemwijzer, and that works pretty good. You get questions about the economy or healthcare, and you can fill in what you think it's the right way to go. Of course, the questions are in Dutch, but I did some research for you guys, and you can install a translation, Google Translate on your Google Chrome, and then you can do the full test with English or Romanian translation. And after the test, you get the parties which are close to you. And what I like to do then is take the manifesto and read what the parties want to do. So that's the 40 pages or something. You don't have to do that, of course, but what I like to do is do the test and see which party is close to you, and then you can do some more research on their
party. So as a responsible voter, you should be very thorough in your research for your vote, to be sure that your vote goes to the party you really want and that the party that you think can do something for you.
Maybe, yeah.
Because you said you read the manifesto, so this takes a lot of time.
You don't have to do that. You also can do only the test and then check which party you like or follow the party in a couple of years. And everybody has to do what they want to do. But, you know, I love democracy. It's an honor. It's a great right to vote. It's good to vote, I think. And I like to spend some research on the party which is going to represent me in the House of the Netherlands. Yeah.
Yeah. Is it more difficult now to choose your information and to choose? Yeah. Sometimes you also want to meet. Yeah, to meet online a candidate. Is not more difficult in this period? They have a lot of videos posted everywhere. But for example, last evening in the news, I saw a reportage of how the social media platforms are filtering your preferences. So you will see immediately on YouTube something that's similar to your preferences. So how is this fair for the voter?
Yeah, that's a difficult one. I personally got a lot of ads from different political parties. So, but that's something I can't answer this question. It's a good question, and I think we as a society have to look into this.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, a good thing about social media is when you get an ad, it also says this is an advertisement of links or
sponsors.
Yeah,
sponsored by. Yeah.
So then you have to think, okay, this is sponsored, so they want something. Yeah.
Do you see any difference in behavior of voters? And so before elections, pre-elections, of course, because we can't know what will happen after. When you compare with 4 years ago, if you follow that process also?
Yes. Yes and no. The big party, the VVD, is still the biggest party, although they had some hiccups along the way. But there are still people are appreciating Mark Rutte for what he's done, and especially during COVID, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So he's still the number one. Number two is still Geert Wilders from the PVV in the polls. And so that was 4 years ago, it was exactly the same. And three, let's say the Christian Democratic Party. So that didn't change a lot, but the feeling is a little bit different. Some people are fed up with COVID, of course. There are another other things where like housing is a problem right now. So the healthcare is something we should think of. So there are different aspects in life, everyday life, but the parties are still the same.
No. As a matter of fact, if you touch this subject of Rutte and COVID, and of course a lot of people are appreciate what he's doing or the government is doing. But still, there is a big, 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 big thing, not to forget the affair regarding the how do we translate this in English? The Toeslag affair.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The money that the parents were given for raising the children and so on, that they were treated as criminals, as a matter of fact, for years and years.
Yeah.
And in spite of this, he is not losing votes.
No.
Not so much, not as expected. So it is like, okay, how do we explain this phenomenon? We have 10 years with Rutte already, and it seems that we are going on.
Yeah, I think that's because the voter wants to vote for a liberal wild right party, and they don't want to vote for Geert Wilders, the PVV, or for Forum from Thierry Baudet. So if you are right and you are liberal, you don't have a lot of options right now.
Mm-hmm. So you mean there is no alternative? That's the explanation.
For some people, there is no alternative. No. Mm-hmm. So, and maybe people are afraid for the other parties, the other right-wing, right parties. So that's why they want to have a bigger favorite day. Mm-hmm. Maybe that's an explanation.
You are born in this country, though you have some Romanian roots from your father, if I remember correctly.
Yes.
You are born in this country, so you are born in a democracy. And what we see as Romanians, or at least I do, in a more or less tolerant country. How do you see the Netherlands as a citizen, as a born citizen here?
You know, I don't know any better. So that's, you can answer your own question maybe. But I'm born here, as you said, and I love it here. There are some things that need to improve, of course, and there are things we be careful for, political also, and we got some left and right parts who are saying things they shouldn't say or they didn't said in the past, but. Yeah, I like it. What would you answer?
So the point is that you, well, I like it very much, but I don't know if I'm the right person to ask. I'm very subjective in a way. I feel like in another life, I was born here. So it's I feel like the fish in the water. So I don't know if I'm the right person to answer this. But I feel that the point of what you said would be... we appreciate very much this country, but it doesn't mean that we can't be critical about it. Yeah. And the vote is the instrument to keep the things floating.
Yes, that's true. It's kind of a poll or what we think of the Netherlands and what we think of what should be important right now, what should we do. We don't vote for politicians, but we vote for ourselves. You know, we vote what we want for this country or for this world or for ourselves.
Mm-hmm. Well, there is a subject that I can't avoid. It's 8th of March, it's the International Women's Day. And yeah. I'm glad to have two gentlemen in this joining me this evening. So, Stefan, what do you think about women in politics? We see two ladies, candidates, leaders of parties.
Yep, it's true and it's very important. And what I always do, and it's a good advice if you do want to have more women in politics, you have to look at the polls right now. And then you have to vote for the woman who's behind the line. So maybe I have to explain it a little better. So
you have a list of candidates?
Yes, you have a list of candidates.
And you have a woman at number three or so?
Yeah,
or
the
four.
Polls are saying, okay, this party gets 10 votes, 10 seats in the house. So you have to vote on the woman number 11 or 12. So they chosen before the rest, so we have one woman more in parliament.
So if that woman that is under the maximum seat of that party,
of the poll,
if she gets more votes, she will be included in the
yes
or will replace someone who has less votes.
Yes,
or not.
Exactly. So in that way we can make sure we got.
It's good to know. It's good to know.
And it works. I don't know how many, I think three women were selected last elections, I guess, in that way. So to do that, I think,
I didn't know. Every year, there is this discussion about people who don't know yet till the last moment what they will vote.
Yeah.
The undecisives. Do you know already?
I do know, yes.
You decided?
Yes, yes.
And your family?
Sorry?
And your family also?
No, I don't think so, no. But I do know which party I'm going to vote for, yes.
I don't want you to tell me who did you choose, but maybe you tell us what themes are important for you.
For me personally?
Yes.
I believe in climate change. That's something I think we should address as a society. Mm-hmm. I am a pro Europe. Maybe that's not a surprise because of my background. So those are things that I think are important. So maybe you can guess already which side I'm on.
No, I don't guess. No, I let our audience, to guess
yes, of course,
your political preference.
Yeah, I'm not going to advise anyone.
No, we don't want that. No, you have to decide for yourself. You got some good advice from Stefan, and I think not only the Stemvisor is not the only instrument. I think there are similar instruments.
No.
Where you can fill in your preferences and you will get a list with parties that are closer to your these preferences.
Yeah.
I don't know if we have questions. I don't see any questions in the chat for the moment. So I would like to ask you, I hear something. No, not so far, Tudor says. I have to acknowledge our technician this evening, Tudor, who is very agile. And I have a personal confession. I was not live with a technician, I think, in 20 years. Of course. For the radio, not with image. With image is the first live I do, or and on a social media. So we are ready to vote, Stefan. We take all our information online and from the online campaign from the parties. And we are going to vote on Wednesday. Do you happen to know why elections are always on Wednesday in the Netherlands?
That's a good question. No.
No?
Do you?
Yes, I know, but I will not tell you because I want to ask also Mayor Boog if he knows why the elections. And I hope that my answer is the good one. My last question for you before we move to our next guest, maybe you wanted to say something that I didn't ask.
Oh, that's a good one. No,
because you prepared for us this evening, and I went to different questions, and maybe I skipped something that it was important for you. And I didn't let you finish your idea, so please.
No, the most important thing is go and vote. It's something we should do, I think. That's my belief. And whatever you vote, it's good. You don't have to justify yourself. Just go and vote, yeah.
You don't have to justify your vote, of course. Only to yourself.
Yes,
after
course.
That.
Yeah.
After that. Okay, let me... we have something from someone. I don't know from who. I'm reading now the question, yes? From Joanna Bukulia. Is there maybe a centralized website to read more about the parties and their leaders, or this is something to do party by party on the individual websites? And she goes on, I also think it's a good opportunity to read more about the parties and their representatives. do these have an obligation to publish their resumes, so the CVs, or their tax declarations, like in other countries, things they believe in, and so on.
Yeah. There is a website. I don't know the name. And I think it's you have to publish those things. Maybe Erik Boog knows that, but you have to publish your declaration, I think. It's on the state website, but...
Financial declarations so.
Yeah.
Okay, so we will have some questions for Mayor Boog. And another question will be, there be debates not to miss on TV or internet? And she says, I'm a little bit lost with Dutch TV programs only. But I guess they are only in Dutch.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Well, I cannot answer this, that they are in Dutch mostly. Of course, they are addressed to a Dutch population. And you have debates on different TV channels. Today, the Radio 1, I heard debates all the time, especially between women, among women. And I also have to add that as a Dutch citizen with a Dutch passport, I guess you passed an integration test. So it's not an easy language, but still.
Yeah, they are speaking quite fast, of course, and to follow.
And they have limited time, not like us today. Yeah.
So 1 minute. Here you go. Yeah, that's difficult. But yeah, I think if you make the test, you have all the time, and then you also can see what are what part thinks and what they want. So that's a good one. And then you have all the time of the world to do it. Yeah.
There is another question coming, Stefan. So one moment of from Ruxandra Talano. Do you think there can ever be a time when the Netherlands and the Dutch psyche, like my Dutch friend calls it, would want to leave the EU? Let's not forget that the Netherlands is one of the founders of the Union.
No. I don't think we're ever going to leave the European Union. There are some parties who want to rebuild the European Union. One party wants to leave the European Union, but most of us are pro EU. Mm-hmm. I'm not afraid.
There are a lot of parties, not only one, I think, that wants to, they want to restructure, to reorganize the European Union, but not to leave. European cooperation is very important.
And no exit soon, I think.
No exit. Stefan, thank you very much for your presence this evening, but I understood that you will stay with us.
Of course, yeah.
Yes? Okay. Yes, please stay with us another half an hour. And now I will welcome our favorite mayor of the Netherlands, Erik Boog. Good evening.
Good evening. Thank you very much.
You know that you are our favorite.
Well, I don't know. I don't know how many mayors you know from the Netherlands.
Well, we know a lot of mayors.
Okay.
We know a lot of mayors, but you are our favorite.
Oh, well, nice
you
to hear.
You were so much with us. In the last years, and you understood our cause. So thank you very much for joining us this evening.
Great to be with you.
I have to say that Mayor Boog is a very experienced politician, a very experienced in public administration for years and years. Well, originally he is a representative of D66, but of course, as mayor, he's the mayor of everyone, no?
Yes, for all the people living in Diemen, from all political parties, yes.
So the mayor in the Netherlands is really the father of all the inhabitants. We want to talk with you about another part of what means political landscape in the Netherlands, and more exactly about the electoral process. because we are just before the elections. So maybe you can help us understand how is working with this list of the parties. So what do you have to do to end on a list as a member of a party?
Yes, now everybody can start a political party in the Netherlands, but you have to have some people who support that. So you have to have some signs from people who support you in the country. In many districts in the Netherlands, you have to have much support. So you can organize or you can participate in the elections. And you have also have to have some money, a small amount of money to participate. You lose that money if you don't have a seat in the parliament, but if you have, you can have your money back. And so everybody can start a political party. And well, you heard 37 political parties participate this time in the elections. It's a record after the Second World War. So many parties. We only had one time so much parties. And a record is in 1922. So we had 52 long parties.
Time ago. Wow.
Long time ago. But this is after the World War, is this a record? So big fragmentation of political parties, yes.
Mm-hmm. But my question was, how can I, as a member of a party, can end on a list for the elections?
Yeah. So every party in the Netherlands has their own structure, so their own process of finding people for the list. Mm-hmm. And there are big differences. So we talked about the PVV from Geert Wilders. That party has only one member, and that's Geert Wilders. And he decides who's going to be on the list and on which position. But in my party, everybody who's a member of the party votes, and then the people with the most votes will end up higher on the list. So, but every part, and some political parties have committees. They gave advice mm-hmm. about the candidates, or has a mixed system. So it's different for every political party. Yes. Mm-hmm.
And how is it working with a list? So you have a list with candidates for the elections. What is important with the position? It also for me is difficult to understand. If I am number five and I finally don't go in the parliament or somewhere else is replacing me, what Stefan said, that if a woman is under the line, on the bottom line, can replace someone else.
Yes, that's possible, but that's democratic process here.
Please explain it.
Yeah. So if you have more votes and you're not at the top, but yes, you can replace some candidate who's in front of you. It happens with many women, but also with people from a special region. So mm-hmm. When people want to vote somebody from Limburg, and there's not someone from Limburg in the top list. So when many people vote for that candidate, it can be that candidate be elected. So I think that's a good thing, because otherwise all the people only look at the top candidate and they don't have to campaign, because they wait how much votes there will be for the leader of the party, and then you don't have to have to campaign for yourself. But I think that's important, that you not only see the leader of the party but all the other candidates, mm-hmm. and that you have to campaign yourself. So mm-hmm. that's a good thing.
How many candidates do you have to prepare for such a list?
Well,
or how long the list should be?
Yeah, that's also to the political party itself, but there is a maximum. So, and that's they look at how many seats you had the last time, and then they will have a formula about how many people you have as a candidate now, but mm-hmm. It's not by law how many candidates a minimum or how many candidates you have to have.
Yeah, that, so you can prepare a long list.
You can prepare a long list. So, you know, mm-hmm. you have only, maybe you can have one seat. You can still have a list of 40, 50 people. Yeah.
It happened to the Social Democrats 4 years ago, I guess, that they lost half of their, or yeah. something like that, if I remember correctly.
Yes, yes, they lost
many seats. They lost yes. a lot of seats.
Yes.
And your yeah. party won some seats or not? Last elections,
we won a little, I think.
Anyway, you didn't lose. Well, didn't lose. Yeah,
yes, and no, I don't know this time, because every time we are in government, we lose some votes.
Yes, that was a question, especially with Rutte. I think it's happening also last time. The parties who are in the coalition lost, and now the party who are now in this coalition seems to lose a little bit or not.
Yes, but there's still polls, so I think many people still don't know what they're gonna vote. So it's I don't know what it's gonna be. So it's. It's very exciting for us to see what it's going to be. I speak to many people, and I've never heard so many people say, I don't know what to vote. Okay. And I will decide at the last moment. So it's yeah. very exciting for us. Yeah.
Well, as a matter of fact, I would have liked to start with this question, but it seems to me that it has more logics now. It's good to mention that we have now elections for the parliament, yeah, so general elections,
yes.
which are different from the local elections. We will not go into that now, but looking at this election, so what do we elect?
We elect the people for parliament, the second chamber, the Tweede Kamer,
the lower chamber, yes.
But it's the most important chamber, because they make the laws together with government, and also they control government. So this is the most important part of parliament. And after this election, we have negotiations between the parties, the most important parties, and they can form a coalition, and that will be the next government. So it's very important you have to vote. Mm-hmm. And these are the most important elections, I think, mm-hmm. in this country. Yes.
Yeah, but can you explain how are the elections for the Senate, for the Eerste Kamer?
Yes, that is not direct. So for the Eerste Kamer, for the first chamber, people vote for the province, for the regions. And then the people who are being elected there, they elect the members of the first chamber. So it's not direct. It's and I don't think that is a good system, but it's for a long time we have that system in Holland.
Mm-hmm. It sounds a very complicated system, to be honest.
It's complicated, but you because people vote for the province, you also vote for the first chamber. So it feels like a double vote, but you don't vote directly for the first chamber.
Yeah, but they are never in the same time. So we have now elections for the Tweede Kamer, but not even the if they are indirect, we don't have for the Eerste Kamer now.
No, and that is that can be a big problem for government, because you can have a majority in the first in the second chamber, you know, in the general election now. But if you don't have a majority in the first chamber, you have a problem, because all the laws must be approved by both chambers. So and so it can be the situation that you have only a majority in one. So you have to negotiate with other parties in the first chamber to get the laws go through.
And that's, for each policy, you need
For each policy
coalition.
And that can be a big problem for government to have the laws through parliament as a whole. Yes,
I have some questions here on the chat. There are it is one side that is directed to D66, but I don't want to make this a platform for D66. We are talking with the mayor of Dima and not with a candidate of D66. No. But maybe you can help us to understand when we look at the themes that the political party are approaching, we don't see anything about protecting migrants and protecting workers. You know, we had a lot of problems with Romanians, but not only with Romanians. Also Polish people working in abattoirs or whatever. So a lot of abuses on the market.
Yeah.
Why do you think that no party is touching such subjects?
Well, it's a complicated situation also, because the cabinet resigned because of the toeslagen affair. The cabinet resigned, and at that moment parliament said on many issues we can't take that decisions on that, so at many issues we have to wait for a new government. And I think this is one of the issues from which measures you can take on this subject, and we have to wait for a new government.
But there is no theme in the debate, in the campaign, that is related in a way, or touching a little bit.
Yeah, but I think many issues are not touched in this election. So that's, and I think for the main public, this is not a big issue.
Okay.
So that's why it's not an issue in the debates or in the election.
It's not a big theme.
Not for the Dutch people, no. Mm-hmm. No, I think for Romanians or other people it is, but not for the Dutch people. But I think that the next government will take measures on this point. Mm-hmm. So I know the minister a little, and I think it's important to take measures on this subject. So it will, but we have to wait for the next government.
Stefan is mentioning in the chat that he has a document listing the opinions from parties about labor migration. So he will send it in the chat to those who asked, and maybe it can be a good instrument to use it to answer more questions. Let's go back to the electoral process, Mayor Boog. So we vote for the Tweede Kamer. The elections for the Eerste Kamer for the Senate will be, I think, 1 year later, or not?
I must think.
Yeah.
When it's, I must think about that.
Or 2 years? When I think 2 years.
Two years.
Yeah, because it happens together with the local elections.
No, with the for the province.
For the province.
Region. Yeah, yes.
Can you explain now the elections for the province so that we can understand? Because we have elections for provinces, but we have also local elections.
Yes, Yes, you have elections, and that will be next year, local elections for the local councils. And then you have also for the province, for all the province in the Netherlands, for all the regions, we have election too, similar like the local elections, but then the people who are elected in the province also elect the members of the first chamber. Yes. And also you have also the European Parliament elections, of course.
Well, yes, those are outside our jurisdictions, let's say, more or less.
And for the local elections, if you live here more than 5 years, and you're not a Dutch citizen, you have not the Dutch nationality, you can also vote for the local elections.
Yes, indeed.
Yes,
we can vote. Those who are longer than 5 years in the Netherlands can vote. Except the fact that we have a very fragmented political scene this year, for these elections. What else can you call it remarkable?
Well, remarkable is the situation with Corona, because of Corona, we have more options to cast a vote. So we have this year new ways to cast a vote. So you can vote in a polling station on the March of 17. You can vote early, but that's especially for voters who belong to the risk groups as a result of the coronavirus. But you can also vote on Monday the 15th and Tuesday, March 16. And a number of polling stations will be opened in all cities on those days. You can authorize someone else to vote if you don't like to vote because of Corona, or you are not in a situation to vote on those days. You can authorize somebody else to cast their vote for you. That's possible, and people from 70 years or older, they can also vote by mail in this election. So those are new ways to cast a vote because of Corona.
Mm-hmm.
So that's new. And while we talked about it, what's new is that we have 10 leaders of a political party who are women. That's not a good thing in Holland. We never had a prime minister, a female prime minister.
That would be nice.
It would be nice, but it's very bad. We don't have that. And there are still two less women in Dutch politics on all levels, in local elections, province, also in parliament. So I hope more women are elected now in the second chamber and also in government, and I hope we have a female prime minister this time. Yes,
I have to say that I am a fan of Sigrid Kaag for a long time.
I don't tell you which candidate.
I will say it. This 66, so it's not so difficult
find her. No, and I'm a fan too, and I hope.
Well, you have to be.
Yes, so and she thinks very international, and that's
yes, and I like. That's why I like her very much.
European, and I think that's very important in this time, because many people are now concentrating on their own country, and not taking an international view. And not an European view. And I think it's very important to have that broader view and not to lock up yourself in a conservative way and only look at your own country. That's very bad.
We need more views from women, indeed. But I have to say, watching the debate on TV, I only saw two women and I neglected to check how the other parties are doing. But you say that there are 10 leaders.
There are 10 leaders. That's a record. So we've never had 10 female leaders of a political party, but still we have too less people, women in politics. So I hope that will be changed after this election. Yes.
Why is important to vote? Very simple. Why is important to go to vote?
Well, it's the basis of our democracy. And that's why I also was very angry when the Romanians could not vote with the early elections we had here, and also we had here in Dima, because it's the most important democratic right you have, because every vote can make a difference. And it's very important because you can influence the direction of the government's policies. And it's also important to have a strong opposition. You have, that's also important to have in a parliament. Well, that keeps the government sharp and on track. And I think voting is very important to give a voice to all the groups in society. And I think there are many important issues with these elections, fighting the corona crisis, climate change, healthcare, education, housing for starting owners. So there are many issues. So I think everybody has to vote. It's very important.
Because you mentioned organizing elections and you mentioned Dima, can you tell us how did you organize for these elections?
Yes, we have a lot of volunteers. We asked people in Dima to volunteer, so to help at the polling stations. And with the counting the votes after that. And many people replied, hundreds of people, hundreds of volunteers wanted to help. So we have enough people for these elections. And because of Corona, we have to have more people, because we have to help, have people who also monitor the whole process, people who are helping people for all the corona measures. So we had to have more people. And because many elder people are not coming because they think it's too high, the risk is too high because of corona. So we ask also younger people to volunteer. That's a big success. So we have a lot of people helping, and we have more polling stations than normal. So we have.
How big is a polling station?
Well, because of Corona, we doubled the size because everybody can have a good distance from each other.
Mm-hmm. And, what does it mean you doubled it? How much?
I don't know exactly, but because it's different, because sometimes we are in a building and sometimes we put on a container on the street.
Okay.
It's different.
So you extended the normal space?
Yes, we extended the normal space because of all the corona measures, because it has to be safe. And we want everybody to vote and not to be scared about corona and the risk. So that's why you can vote on more days. And we have enough space in all the polling stations. Yes.
Mm-hmm. We are getting closer to the end of our meeting. I would like to give you the opportunity to say something that I didn't ask.
Well, you asked why on Wednesday we always vote.
Well, that was my last question for you. But if you don't have anything, can you tell us why is Wednesday and not a Sunday? We are used to vote on Sunday.
Well, it's a little bit difficult in the Netherlands, but because Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, it's because of religious reasons. Because several groups have on Friday, Saturday, or Sunday their religious ceremonies and special days. So in Holland, we don't vote on that day. And if you have elections on Monday, you can't prepare it well because of the weekend before. So Then is Wednesday the most obvious day to held the elections? And because many times we have the elections, the poll stations also in schools. And most schools have on Wednesday that they end early with classes. So then it's easier to organize at the schools. But this time we don't have the poll station at the schools because of Corona. But most of the times we use school buildings for our elections. So it's a help most, so also principal, but also practical why we have elections on Wednesday. Yeah.
Yes, yes. So this would have been my answer also, Stefan. That's why we vote on Wednesday in the Netherlands. And I go a little bit further and I say on Sunday, it's family day and it's not a working day and voting is actually working.
Yeah.
Because you have to. You have to go to work for your country.
Yes.
In one way, you go to vote. You choose the future of the country.
Yes. Yes.
Now, thank you both very, very much for your time. It was a very nice evening together. I hope that our audience also enjoyed our conversation and that they... that they got something back, some good information that maybe will help them to vote, or if they don't vote this year, maybe next year when they or the next years when they become citizens of the Netherlands. Thank you again. This session was organized by RomPro Foundation. With the aim of familiarize the community, the Romanian community in the Netherlands, with the political, with that Dutch political landscape and the electoral process. Have a nice evening. Bye bye.
And all votes.